Sweet legs, Jordan.
If we play any more than that, we're probably going to get a copyright strike. Hello, it's Friday on Geek.com's Facebook and Twitch TV feeds. We have a very special crew today for a very special live stream. Yeah, I'm Jordan Miner, senior editor at Geek.com.
Alice Newcombe-Beale.
Jeffrey Wilson.
Just video game fans.
Video game people.
Video game people.
People, Nintendo fans.
Also, importantly, adults.
Adults.
We are all adults. We are some of us
adults. Adults who like cardboard.
Yeah, some of us are drinking adult beverages.
Yes.
Yes.
But we're going to play with this children's toy, Nintendo Labo. This new sort of like game accessory sort of DIY maker thing for the Switch. You may have seen it is cardboard, not like this cardboard, Google Cardboard, but like.
But relatively close, a second cousin, if you will.
Yeah.
Similar in concept.
These cardboard toys that you're folding up, you're creating different sort of, again, like accessories that you put the Switch tablet into and make your own toys. It's like a Lego Mindstorm kind of thing.
Yeah.
It's a coding aspect to it. It's very cool. A big part of it is actually just building the thing. So we're going to build some of them now that we have it.
Oh, God.
Yeah, we just got ours
yesterday.
Anything
can happen. Live TV.
Yep, it's 420. Anything can happen.
Yes. Anything can happen.
So we're going to start off with this simple RC car, but we have a few options for what the big build is going to be. Too bad Buzzy's out. This is kind of like Will It Boot, but for cardboard.
A little bit, yeah.
So leave questions, comments in the field. We'll get to them. Specifically, we want to know, what should our big build be? Should it be the fishing rod? Should it be the little house? Or should it be the motorcycle handle? So if you have any takes on that, we'd love to know, and then we'll pick the one that we decide to go with.
I'll say I'm pro little house. It sounds kind of adorable to build.
I've already built the fishing rod at the preview event. So.
I mean, either way, honestly, I want to go into this blind. Here.
There it is.
So you got the motorcycle down here, and the little house and the fishing rod over there in this corner obscured by the label. But I've never built anything with Labo before. Jeff, have you done any Labo-related activity before?
I know next to nothing about Labo.
Cool. I mean, yeah, it's just out today.
It sounds kind of cool.
Yeah.
Great, I'm way into going into this blind.
Mm-hmm.
This sounds super fun. Where are the instructions? Let's get cracking.
They are right here on this Nintendo Switch.
Amazing.
That we have. So it's the cardboard sheets, but also the game cartridge, which has the games, but also these really intuitive menus and whatnot.
All right, so as someone that has virtually no, experience with the Switch, let alone Nintendo Labo, I'm excited to see how easy this is to actually put together.
I mean, so it's theoretically for children, so.
Fun for ages 6 to 60.
Yeah.
You know? So, all right, the Labo is happening. Cool. Your controllers will be updated. Okay. Updating controllers. We're
a little download
action. Yeah, we're doing a little firmware update here, I guess.
Yep.
With the magic of live TV.
Yeah, but let's look at these sheets for a minute before we start poking holes out of them. It's just cardboard.
Okay, so yeah, and today you mentioned that they actually made these templates available for free.
Yes, yes.
Oh, okay. So it doesn't matter, like these are kind of like single use, like once you put them together as far as, to my understanding.
Yeah, yes.
Like you put them together, and then you can't really take them apart again, right?
Right. You can like draw on them and sort of customize them like that. But yeah, you're not gonna it's not gonna the piano isn't sharing pieces with the fishing rod.
Okay.
It's not like some Lego nonsense where
the
pieces stuff are very modular.
It's very bespoke.
These are very much exclusive to this specific build.
Right.
But that is nice because then you don't get your parts mixed up.
Exactly.
And they can put it all on one sheet. And this is all the parts we need?
For these first two, yes.
That's amazing. Yep. Wow, we put it all on this, it's only a little bit bigger than the size of like a legal pad.
Right, but again, this is the simplest build. So
we're starting off slow. So beginners, start me off slow. Update is complete.
Cool.
We're going to move along here.
I should also mention I'm wearing this Atari hat.
Atari products?
Yeah, we're doing Geek Pick of the Day. Check that out every day. We're having new kind of cool products. One of them was this Atari hat that has speakers in it that plays music.
Cool.
So
do we want to pipe something? I'm sad we can't pipe in some like, you know, Wii tunes or something like that. Some Wii music tunes.
But we can, I mean, I can play some Wii tunes.
Let's do it. Some Wii tunes?
Weeb tunes.
Okay, so anyway, we're gonna start with make here. Do I wanna do practice?
No, that's just a build.
Okay. So that's so when you first boot up Labo,
you build this.
It's going to show you like basic instructions to build this little like Joy-Con holster.
Yep. There we go.
Okay.
Yeah.
So
again, these are
pretty
simple enough.
I want to just skip the tutorial.
And the cool thing about this whole Labo project, it kind of brings Nintendo back to its roots.
Totally.
As a card maker.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. That's a very valid point. Like, yeah, that's what they did originally. Hold forward to make the video play. Can I just X out of this menu?
Yeah.
Let's do that.
Again, for kids, it's good that they are very...
No. Yeah. Please, be explicit with the instructions.
All right. It's not... We can just skip through all this.
Okay, cool.
It doesn't know if we've actually built it or not, so we can just.
All right.
I mean, this will show off too the interface, how that works too.
Sure.
So you can use a touchscreen, obviously, to rotate stuff. It is a tablet.
Roughly, how much time did it take to build the piano?
4 hours.
Four hours.
Yes.
Yeah. Take it from me. He was at this all day yesterday.
Yeah. So, yes, doing all this, I'm holding
down. Do all this stuff to fast forward through the
But it wants you to, it wants to make sure that you know that you can rotate it like this.
Oh, okay, so here's something I want to show off, is they're providing you not just with flat instructions like you would find in a typical manual. This is a 3D rendering of the piece of cardboard, so you can move that all around there.
At any time, go through the instructions very easily. Yeah.
Zoom in and out. Yep. Okay, and it's telling me, what is it? Oh, and you can pan like that. Mm-hmm. And what is this? You can reset the camera. Okay, so now then, let's get practicing. Take a good look at the screen, okay.
Very important thing to note, Jeff, you should take a note of this.
Yes.
The key thing about Labo is to get a good crease. Whenever you want to fold things, it's very, crease it so
good,
that it
good
can...
crispy
yeah,
crease.
So it can bend well, and that's the number one thing it'll impress
if
on
there's
you.
If there's anything I'm good at, it's creasing.
Yes. Yeah. Question.
Are there any choking hazards?
Huh. I mean, cardboard, you can eat paper, right? My sister ate paper.
I mean, well, no, let's get real for a second, okay? The cardboard, no,
paper cut,
but this stuff does come packaged, and you're looking at a variety of rubber bands and little plastic washers and some strings. So yes, definitely a choking hazard here.
Mm-hmm. Very good question.
I think this does say that it is software, so it is rated by the ESRB. It is rated E for everyone, but it is rated at ages six and up, and it does have a disclaimer that adult assistance may be required.
You also need to own a Nintendo Switch, which is an expensive piece of video game hardware.
Unfortunately, it's not as open source as all that. You still do need this relatively expensive piece of hardware.
Yeah.
Speaking of price, what is the price of the Labo?
So we got the variety kit right here, which comes with the piano, the RC car, the motorcycle handles, fishing rod, little house, all that together for $69.99.
Okay.
$70.
$70, which is a less nice way of saying it. There's also the robot kit, which I've not had time to build, which is $80, which is kind of, you may have seen, it's this whole backpack. There's video of me wearing it on
featured by Bill Nye.
Bill Nye today.
Bill Nye was wearing it.
Yeah, but we've only had this for a day, so we've had time to get to that. Question. You want to get started?
I've
been able to test this aspect of it, but do you feel like a cat would attack this?
Oh, absolutely.
I don't have a cat. I
know. Yeah, we all know Jordan's takes on pets, but I have a jerk cat at home, and he would absolutely just bat the shit out of this.
Cats are very pro-box.
Pro-box, yes.
Very
definitely.
Pro-box. Yeah.
Pro-cardboard, pro-box.
So it's going to walk you through this.
All right, so...
You can also use the...
Okay. How do I talk forward?
And then you have to hold the
there
trigger to go
There are two
faster.
Steps to complete. I really wish we could get a feed on this, but without turning it around, but... Anyway, two steps to complete, one out of two, making the RC car an antenna. Take two parts out from sheet A. Okay, so as you can see here, it's highlighting the pieces. It's highlighting the pieces here. Okay, I'm trying to get a good angle here, Weston. There we go. Okay, so it's trying to show us what pieces we need to punch out of this cardboard template here. It highlights them in color. So I'm going to do that.
Now, there are two here, so you can both be doing this at the same time.
Okay. Now, what are the pieces?
Oh, wait, what?
There are two versions of this on this sheet. You see how it's like, yeah.
There's two versions of
There's two RC cars.
So where's the second antenna?
This one and this one.
I'm failing to see where you're
pointing. I think there's only one antenna. But the antenna is also, the antenna is purely
okay,
decorative.
So you know what? Here, let me punch this out for you, Jeff, and you can follow along.
Yeah. Okay.
The antenna is also purely decorative.
Oh, is it?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
You put it on your
pure aesthetics.
Yes.
Yeah. Aesthetics.
Okay, so these are coming out pretty easy. I'm not. They're coming out of. These are called sprues, by the way.
Yeah, I can use some hot box lore.
In the model making community, these would be called sprues.
Okay.
Yeah. So thankfully, we don't have to like sand any edges down or prime
some
anything.
Zoids ass toys.
Yeah, we don't have to do any of that.
Gundam.
Yeah. Gundam. So we have some stuff that's gonna like pop out here. It's coming out pretty easy.
Question.
Someone's asking what's happening on the screen right now.
It's showing what to pop out of the sheet right now.
Right.
It's highlighting on the sheet what you're trying to pop out of it.
So yeah, as you can see, there are little beveled areas here on each piece of cardboard to show you where all the folds and creases are supposed to go.
So here, you take that one.
I'm going to pop out the second one here. And then we can hopefully get cracking on some race car building.
Yeah, Jeff's getting it. Yeah, you want to make some creases.
Yeah.
Okay. Perforated edges.
Yeah. All right. So theoretically, after you punch this out of the sprue, you can just fold it along all the creases and get a head start on this.
Yeah.
So
it's
pretty
easy. It's like the Lego thing.
Hard to mess it up.
Yeah, it's like the Lego thing.
We'll see about that.
Challenge accepted, Jeffrey Wilson says. Okay,
but sometimes they'll throw you a curveball, so maybe where you think the build's going isn't where it's going.
Okay, so anyway, we've got those punched out. I'm going to skip forward here.
Okay, you can hold also the R trigger to go faster, too.
Okay, so... Yeah. There we go.
Question.
Would a cast member from the Broadway musical Cats attack this set?
They're really big on audience involvement, so my answer is probably yes.
Grizzabella. That's about all I know about
Grizzabella.
Grizzabella, McCavity, all those.
Andrew Lloyd Webber. I'll play a song from Cats.
Thanks.
Memories.
So fill me in. Like, do you actually play the piano? I don't know this about.
A little bit. I do.
A little bit. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So right now it's instructing us to do exactly what we started doing, which is to fold along the beveled edges here.
Okay.
What are you doing with that screw, Jordan?
I'm gonna play some songs from Cats.
Nice. Aww, little kitties.
That's what it is, right?
Yep. That's basically it. That's basically it. All right.
I'm a bit confused about what I should do towards the end of this folding procedure.
Well, here, let's take a look at the actual printout here. There you go.
A little glare that goes.
Oh, are you okay?
Okay. I suppose to
get your reading glasses.
It's supposed to splay out. Is that what it is?
Well, there you go. We're doing that.
Bent. Yeah, that's bent.
All right. Okay. So now it's instructing us to kind of do. Wait, what?
There's a lot of interlocking tab mechanisms.
Tabs.
Oh, okay. So we're gonna fold this down, and these are going to kind of interlock here. Cool, cool, cool. All right. So we got that, and then this. Oh, if I had to guess, but I will follow the instructions.
There we go.
Question.
Oh, okay. So then this part goes in there.
Do you feel like this is going to be an educational tool?
That's what they're totally trying to make it into, for sure.
That's what I'm getting from this.
Totally trying to get into like the Lego sort of maker, like even kids like Minecraft, like that kind of like creation space. And something
edutainment, you know.
And something that we probably won't get into during the stream, but in addition to these like preset kits, you can also reprogram all of these. Like they have a kind of like a programming language where you can like. Create all these like if-then statements.
Like you were saying, Lego Mindstorm.
Totally.
Stuff.
So it teaches these kids these very kind of rudimentary.
Are you confused here, Jeff?
Coding.
Here's how mine looks.
You bend it in. Is that what you do?
You're on the right track here. And those should fold into those two holes.
There we go.
All right.
I'm starting to feel. Thank you, Alice. See, teamwork, dream work.
DreamWorks.
DreamWorks.
Oh, it's very sturdy.
But
now.
I think they very much get this education for something
that was, you know, a loose piece of cardboard 2 seconds ago. This is an incredibly sturdy piece of material.
Yeah.
So as you flip it over, be sure none of the six legs get bent. Okay, so what
get
we're looking
bent.
At. Get bent.
Bent.
So we're going to put this guy down.
Yep. Okay.
And I guess this is pretty much the finished product.
Yeah.
Yours looks relatively the same, except it doesn't have any of the sign stuff on it. It doesn't have any of the signage. But anyway, we're going to continue forward here. The RC car is done. Printed side face down. Okay, so we're doing the antenna next. And it was literally just to fold these two things in. So there you go. It, very explicit instructions. Attaching the Joy-Con. Okay, so can I use... this?
I'm gonna give you mine also.
Okay, so that's what.
Actually,
we're
no, gonna you, do. Yes, you have to use the ones that are paired with it. Actually, so you do have to take that one.
So
off.
This one.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right.
So
yeah.
What am I doing here? Fuck.
But meanwhile, I'm going to take Jeff's and then use mine, so we can have two going at once.
Ah.
Oh, okay.
Nice. Okay, so we're doing this. It's telling me to attach this to the rails. Okay, so the little areas where the Joy-Cons would normally go. This piece of cardboard is going to slot right in, actually.
Meanwhile, so I'm going to show off putting the Joy-Con into the thing itself.
It's pretty amazing. You have this high-tech device, and you slide in a piece of cardboard on top of it.
It was made just for this. That is its purpose. Okay, slots right in. It's very snug and secure. Okay, so let's attach the Joy-Con controllers. All right, so I'm going to take mine here, and it seems pretty simple. I'm just going to make sure that I'm doing this right.
You can see mine as a model if you need it.
Okay, so, wow. Okay, yeah, pretty foolproof here. It's, even someone as decrepit as me can handle this.
Someone who's so close to death. Question.
Close to death. All right, so it's
could
showing.
You use pizza boxes or any other type of
It's just cardboard, dog. Yeah.
Theoretically, dude. Yeah, use whatever you want.
I mean, granted, this has the design stamped into the.
Yeah, you have to bend some.
It has
the
perforations and all that. But
But like we said, they
hell
came
yeah.
out, they made the templates for all this stuff open source. So if you just print out the template and put it over a adequately sized piece of cardboard, you could just take an X-Acto knife and do this at home.
Yeah, you can totally do it. It's awesome.
With adult supervision, of course.
Yeah.
But, okay, so it's telling me to attach the Joy-Cons, and is that literally just the...
It locks in?
It's pretty much just...
Okay, yeah. It's just looping that final step, so I'm assuming that's just what I've got to do.
Yeah, that's it.
All right.
Ooh.
Whoa!
Oh, look at that!
So what's happening here is that
it's like BattleBots.
The HD rumble of the Switch Joy-Con controller is vibrating in such a way that it...
So I'm going to say I'm done here. Forward.
It's like the Rez trance vibrator.
I love it! The Toy-Con RC car is done. What does it look like to you?
It kind of reminds me of the Moon Patrol buggy. Back in the arcade days, just rumbling along the lunar wasteland.
Lunar surface.
I'm coming.
He's coming for me. I haven't even started yet. Come on, no fair. All right, when runs best on a flat, smooth surface. Well, we got that.
Same.
You know, I am a flat. Okay, so hold on. So for the viewers at home, this is what I get once I'm finished. This is how I'm going to interact with the Nintendo Labo, and it has the Joy-Cons attached to either side, and... Ah! Oh, God!
There we go.
and we're off. Okay, I'm
They're mating!
Wow, the Labos are alive!
It is alive! Okay, so if I engage one of the Joy-Cons, it's going to turn it left. The other one right, if it was similar to like the way treads would work on a tank or something.
Oh, I win.
I won. Yeah.
The Labo attacks.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Push him off the edge. There we go. Okay, so.
So, yeah, congratulations, team. We made the Labo. We made the simplest one.
What I am a little confused about, though, is that there's all these pieces are left over.
Yeah, so
I'm left with the same kind of confusion after I finish an IKEA shelf where I've got all of these pieces left over.
So these are for the kind of more high level kind of things they suggest.
Yeah, as you can see, this is all we use to make this.
These could be like targets. So something I should explain, and it relates to the piano. Another big thing that for how Labo works is that the Switch, the right Joy-Con here, if we can get a view of that. This little black, yeah, this little black thing. It's an IR camera, and it's an IR camera.
Oh, okay.
And a lot of this stuff is based on that IR camera, looking at pieces like this that have this sort of reflective tape on them, and interpreting that. So the piano keys all have that tape on them. You could, like, for example, put reflective tape on these targets.
Is that tape included with the Labo?
Yes, it is.
Okay.
You could put reflective tape on these targets, and then if the cannon of your RC car were to see it, it would, like, make a noise or something.
Oh, that's really cool.
It could tell if you hit the target or something. So that's what these are for, is that sort of extra stuff.
So there's the magic. That's where the magic happens.
Yeah, it's all this IR stuff. And it finally makes sense as to why the Joy-Con had this IR camera, because until now, like,
It was useless.
Only that 1-2 Switch game where you eat the sandwich, that was like the only, Switch game that had people like, why is this in here?
Eating heroes and battling RC cars.
Yeah.
Sweet.
Okay, so that's done.
So magic. That's great.
So, do the folks at home have any anything
have
they want to see
for
the big build? Now that we're warmed up here. Nope.
Okay. All right, Jeff. What are we doing?
Oh, sorry. What were you asking?
Do people have any? Do people want to see us build any particular one out of these three?
I would say just go with your heart.
Okay. I've already built the fishing rod, but
my
heart
says little house.
Little house.
Little house.
Little house. It is, Jeff. We're gonna build this old house.
Okay. Oh. Little house. So that's gonna
let me get rid of this nonsense. Yep. Got to clear out some room.
Yeah.
Let me take these Joy-Cons out of here because I will inevitably need them. I'm sure.
Yep.
Go. Be free, little robots.
Be free.
Be free. All right.
So little house, you're gonna need the white sheets.
All the white sheets.
The white
Jeff.
Sheets.
Yeah. So they're all beneath the box.
All beneath the box?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Cool.
So they're very.
So discard the rest.
All the white sheets. These are blues. Here's a few whites.
They got letters. So A is the first. Yeah. So.
All right. So we're going to close out here.
A, B, C, D.
And select the. Oh, there it is. Yeah. When you go to the. Is this just the variety thing? Like, we'll get a different one if we have the robot one?
Yep.
So, yeah, you can see all of the various projects up here, and we're just going to select the house, and it's going to run us through all of the instructions we need to build the house. So let's connect the right Joy-Con wirelessly. Okay, so I'm going to take you out.
Yeah, there's a little clack. Clutch.
Cool.
Yep.
All right. I am here. Checking the Joy-Con. Toy-Con.
The Toy-Con.
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 It's been
get
rebranded.
It right. Attach the right Joy-Con to the house.
Oh no. I'm sorry. Okay. So you're already in the play mode.
Oh.
So it already thinks you built it.
Oh.
Yeah. You got to go to make.
Oh heavens no.
You got to make. So yeah, there's make, play, and discover. And what's cool about discover is that it. You know, I was explaining how it all works. It explains to kids. How it all works too. It's
okay.
It's explaining. It's not. It's like this IR stuff and like the physics and whatnot.
Okay,
kind of more
so
the more
is this
tech
just,
of it.
Yeah, that's how it's educational. Yeah.
Okay.
There are 5 steps to complete. Okay, significantly more complicated than the RC car.
Sure is.
Make sure.
But less complicated than this piano.
It'll take us less than 4 hours.
Yeah.
But more than 45 minutes.
Yes.
Okay, so make sure you've got the plastic bag with the special parts inside. We definitely have that. We'll be using some later. Mm-hmm. Making the main body. All right, so.
Oh, wow, okay.
So Lord.
Let's go, team.
So how about you punch out A.
A?
And I'll
Whoops, that was quick.
And I'll start punching out B.
I will play us another song.
Please.
Woo! Labo everywhere.
Field questions.
Yeah. I've already
taken that out of there.
High end elements a lot.
Wow, these just practically fall out of here.
Hot take, I think that this variety kit is cheaper and also better than the robot kit.
I mean, I haven't seen the robot kit, so I can't speak to how cool it is.
I mean, a certain type of child will get a kick out of wearing a robot suit
I'm
for sure. But in terms of just
I'm certain of it. A lot of paper. A lot of
parts.
Cool. So how affluent are you with making models, Jeff?
I haven't made a model since I was roughly 12 years old.
So did you ever do like the snap type models or like the or were you always using like model glue?
I was using model glue. I never snapped.
Never cement. Okay, I couldn't be trusted with that kind of patience, so my parents knew better than to just buy me the anything but the snap type models. Because me just like putting two pieces together and then waiting 24 hours for that junk to
dry yeah.
was not gonna work. But this is great. This definitely checks my builder box.
And that's good about telling you, hey, you only need these pieces right now. Don't worry. Like,
hey, whoa.
It keeps
hold
things,
your horses.
It keeps things in like small enough batches.
Oh, did I
like,
pop out everything?
No. You're fine. And honestly, you're going to need to pop it all out anyway.
Right, but it keeps batches manageable.
Yeah.
Oh, I see. Yeah.
Hopefully we can.
I see. Yeah, it's a lot of parts right now.
Yeah.
So anyway, I'm gonna put this, okay, this sprue put this back right there. Over here. Did you get all your pieces?
Yeah, they're all popped. All
right, away we go. And remove these pieces. Thanks. All right, we'll just pop those.
Meanwhile, I'm playing some text adventure over here for Discover Mode.
Whoa, that's cool.
Yeah.
All right, we don't need that part yet.
Professor Gary from Gary's Mod. Is this Gary's Mod?
Gary's Mod.
Yeah.
Everything is Gary's Mod if you want it. All right, we're doing this. I'm definitely not sober enough for building a house.
like Tom Hanks in the Money Pit.
Oh, yeah. let's start by making the chimney. I dropped a piece, but that's okay. Oh, gosh.
You got it?
There we go. Got it.
All right.
Is this piece you or me? I think that's you.
Oh, no. Oh, Lord.
That's you,
look
buddy.
At the matched pieces now.
Get you. Start full. Start creasing,
looks,
buddy.
This is it. Okay.
That's it. Okay. Well, if we were ever confused, we can tilt around the camera.
It's all this 3D effects here you're not seeing.
Okay. So, yeah. Wow. It's like I'm playing L.A. Noire all over again.
you can play on the Switch. That's when I last played it.
Huh. Yeah. All right. So, get to creasing, buddy. All right. So it's telling me to, or Jeff rather, to fold along all the creases.
And there are several creases here, if the camera can spot this.
All right, and then
it's more a little bit more complex than the last one.
Yep.
Yes, significantly.
Again, we're warmed up, so.
All righty.
It's so cathartic to watch other people do this after watching me.
You're like, dance, my puppets,
waste
dance.
Away on the piano for 2 days.
Your respite is well earned. Yeah. I saw you doing.
That's why I wanted to have it done, though, because I wanted, like a cooking show, I wanted to have it, well, here's one already pre-built.
Yeah.
In the oven.
Yeah. I made this one earlier. Here it is, magically in the oven. Bam.
Question.
Yeah.
How hard would this be to assemble hot?
I don't break the law.
Yo, first of all, no one here is insisting that anyone break the law.
No. Yeah.
Certainly, I could see, this is a very zen-like experience, honestly.
I find it relaxing.
That's how it is for me when I'm building anything out of a kit. Mm-hmm. It gravitates between zen-like and incredibly rage-inducing. That's a very fine line for me. It's like, either it's like, oh yeah, we're chilling out, we're making, some models, we're making the Saturn V rocket.
Right.
Saturn V rocket.
That was my last Lego build, the Saturn V rocket.
I will say the thing that, theoretically, if I were theoretically paranoid, I would be concerned about breaking it.
I am concerned about breaking this thing. I'm being very gentle.
That's my only concern, is like maybe tearing something, but this stock of cardboard is pretty hardy.
Is this supposed to go like this?
Let's go back and it's going to show you how the build is supposed to work.
There's something to say about the design. Just building the piano. It's very. Pieces like reinforcing themselves. There's a lot of redundancies and things that help it keep its shape. So it's very. It's like the design level. And I find that very impressive.
Are we using the right part? Are we using the right part, Jeff? Come on, man.
That's the only part that has that shape.
Yeah, that's got to be it.
So if you fold...
It should be the same shape, regardless.
If you fold...
we're going to be here Monday morning for
one cool thing. Us building Labos. Can you go back for a second to
sure.
the previous step?
Yeah. Oh, what are we missing here? Are there like two flaps?
Two flaps?
Oh!
Great.
Of course!
They fold?
Fold it up, and then these go up like this, I think.
Okay.
Of course!
Question.
The files are inside the computer, Jeff.
Just like the last time I built the house.
There's no chance that Nintendo would just sell these pre-assembled, is there?
No.
No, just ask someone on like Fiverr to do it for you.
Yeah.
TaskRabbit. Because again, building it is like the big deal. Like the mini games are cool, but it's really the building it that is the experience.
Okay.
So.
And then,
Wow, that was a fast, okay.
Fast transition there. There, we got it. We got it.
That, and do I just hold it there for a while?
No, you just hold that, and then that'll wrap around and lock in place.
Oh, wait, there's a little tab down there.
Yeah, there you go.
Let's see here.
Maven.
Gabbo.
Labo.
Gabbo. All right. Nice, firm crease. And then this thing?
This is going to be the new ASMR videos, if he was making Labo and whispering.
Oh, yeah. No.
Hold on. Can I make
it? I got the scar bar. Oh, man. That's very cool. Miyamoto is a genius.
Yeah. Well, there we go. New ASMR. Everybody knows.
Tune in next week. We're going to stream God of War.
Mouth sounds. It's going to hurt. We get, yeah, hold on. I'm going to my beer right into the thing. Wow.
See, fun for all ages.
Oh.
Oh, we.
Hey, amazing. We built the chimney. All right, so now this part, which is like this, is going to be like this. We're going to fold it up like so. And
can you buy Labo in your traditional toy stores? Where do you get it from?
Yeah, any place fine video games are sold. Ooh. You can go to the Nintendo World Store here in New York if you want to.
Amazing.
What if I'm in Omaha, Nebraska?
How do you go to a damn Target? I don't know.
What?
Sure.
Wait, what?
Yeah, it's a video game.
All
so.
Right. Am I? Hold on. Let's. Oh, no. Don't do that. Don't do that, Alice. There we go.
So no, this whole 3D rotation, it really is the MVP of this thing. It really gives you a good idea.
Yeah, these menus are great.
The menus are great.
Yeah.
Great menus, great build. Okay, there we go. A good bake.
It's like building that plastic gun in, like, was that X-Men 2?
Sure.
What?
Oh, what? Like the movie?
Yeah.
Oh, like a 3D printed gun or something?
Yeah, X-Men told you they put like a plastic gun or something like that.
All right, so I got this one and this one right here. Maybe.
Didn't win my
he
dreams.
Doesn't want to admit anything. All right, so these are going to just slot in here.
Oh, they're plastic guns. Yeah. Oh, that. Yeah. I'm going to do a very nice.
Thank you, Pete.
I'm going to do a very aesthetic thing right now.
All right, so we're fast forwarding here. We got those slotted in.
Fast forward.
Hey, the chimney is done. Cool. We got that.
All right.
Fantastic. Now we get to do this big old piece.
Okay.
You can see how far along you are, too, in that little thing in the corner.
Yeah, there's a little. Yeah, but this is a step. Mind you, this is step 105.
Yes.
So we're only about a quarter of the way done with step one. Well. So about 10% of the way. So let's try and speed things along, I guess. We're going to do...
Folding?
If you need me to like fold anything, I mean, yeah, we have three hands here, so if I could be folding stuff and creasing stuff.
Yeah, you know
what? Speed things up.
Oh, yeah, we started to start creasing and folding.
That's what helped me and Will beat all those kids at the preview event in the race to make the fishing rod.
Teamwork beats children.
Yeah. Bodied.
All right.
All right, we're just going to, I'm just going to do a preemptive strike here and just...
Yeah, you know what? You know, folding was my biggest fear, that I would break or tear the crease, but they're pretty durable.
Yeah, it's like folded totally in half. It's, yeah.
Just mash it.
Yeah.
Just go nuts. All right, creasing. We are creasing.
Labo House on the Prairie.
Yeah. It's old Labo. Oh my gosh, so many. Oh wait, hold on. Sponge stickers now?
Sponge stickers. That's for holding the Switch in place. That's on this piano too. So that's gonna be in the little bag.
Okay, so finally, we're doing stuff that's irreversible now, guys. Hold your breath.
That's a way to put it.
I'm just like, you can't. Well, that was always the thing with the decals. Like, I'm always just like, you know, shaky. I'm always shaky the moil with these freaking.
It's Shaky the Moil.
You guys ever heard of Shaky the Moil?
Oh, Jesus.
I have a visual, though.
I bet you do. Anyway, we're going to... Where is it? Hey, Jordan, you got any foam?
Huh? There's no other one?
I'm not...
Which part are you looking for?
There should be some little adhesive foam.
Adhesive foam?
Yeah. Like a little, yeah. These are the little IR stickers.
Maybe it's in the box.
And this is a bit of string.
The sponge one, right?
Yeah, that's what it's getting at. Because I don't want to mess something up.
How many pieces do you need?
It's these two little pieces.
Oh, dip! It's these pieces.
Oh.
Jordan, did you maybe put them on?
I sure did. You know, though, those might not be these. Those are just for. Holding
a little bit of traction.
Yeah.
Okay.
So that might not be that might not be the end of the world.
You know what? Screw it. We're going.
Yeah. We're raw dogging.
Okay.
Live TV.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh Christ.
Let's give me the marker stickers.
Are these? It's this one. It's this little template here. Jeez. Okay. All right, and it's telling me explicitly there are little shapes cut out of this. Can we get a zoom in on that? Enhance, Weston.
So yeah, this is the IR tape, the reflective tape for the IR stuff. You're gonna need that.
But as you can see, there are little pieces cut out, and it's supposed to get very very specific pieces to attach to very specific spots. So I can see how this might be. One of the more advanced builds.
Yeah, you see, I'm already building my Macross models.
Man, some Gundams.
Your parents help you hook it up.
Yeah, there we go. Putting that there. Advance.
So, would you say, Jordan, this is so far the more intense build?
I don't know. You built
the piano is the most complicated of the.
You built a freaking
piano.
You built a freaking instrument. Okay.
Yeah, I'm going to do this very aesthetic thing right here.
Please.
You'll see what I'm doing soon enough.
Okay, fold all those pieces.
Okay.
Thank God we're done with that. Thank God we're done with stickers for the time being. Good Lord. Anytime I see the word decal, I just get cold sweats. I'm just like, no.
Meanwhile, check this out.
Wait a minute.
Oh, I'm just playing Doom.
Homeboy's playing Doom? On the Switch?
Alice is doing this labor and you're playing Doom?
That was a really fancy Switch holder. So it's got piano.
You know, that's classy as fuck, man. I like that.
Wayne Newton's
Doom.
Parents will need like a vacuum cleaner or a broom. There's lots of
there's little nubbins, a lot of little parts.
Yeah, there's definitely some detritus that's being spread around. Okay, so locking these into place here. Okay.
I'm just showing off that you can use Labo for whatever you want. You can use it as a way to look at Doom differently.
Sure.
So
I'm definitely looking at it differently.
Yeah. Mm. But okay, that's good enough for that bit.
Okay. Good bit though.
Thanks. Anything else you need me to fold?
Not right now. Okay. I'm just kind of we got all this creased up.
I'm trying to prep some small parts
and
here.
And we're gonna jam this part in there, and that's gonna fold down. Okay, so we're all right. Hold on to your butts.
It's very satisfying though when it all comes together like this. I find.
What's up?
I do find it satisfying when it comes together. Like it all snaps into place. Like
it is very.
The vision comes together.
This feels very secure. Like it's not gonna fall apart. And it's a miracle that there's like no glue or like other assembly required.
No, even the fact that the keyboard keys like are just the cardboard. Like the rubber bands are used very sparingly.
Yeah, these actual pieces. This actual hardware?
Yeah, just like on a physical. Just, again, it's just the design of it, I find it very impressive.
It is very cool. Yeah. It's wild how it uses all these different components very uniquely. It, like, oh, hey, we just made some robots by making a couple of your Joy-Cons vibrate.
It makes me think, actually, like, that they were thinking of this before the Switch was even out.
Yes.
And that it just took until now for it to be ready.
Mm. Yeah, it seems a little too deliberate for them to not have planned this in advance.
But this is their big push to get Switch to 20 million sold this year.
They very well might. So they very well might.
That and Smash
Brothers. Coming to a classroom near you.
Yeah.
Okay, this is the left-hand side. And, like this. And we're going to jam that in there. All right.
So starting to get a little vision of what this is going to be.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. And we're in.
I got in.
One day,
you're gonna eventually also be building some little nubbins like this for it too.
Screws, some little sprockets.
Yeah, but they're like
some little, spacely sprockets.
Yeah, they're little buttons and cranks.
Sprockets.
Yeah, that's the only. Yeah. I mean, this is either a nut, a bolt, or a sprocket. I don't know where the line is drawn between those three.
No, yeah, it's arbitrary.
It's arbitrary. Yeah. Much like the rest of my life.
There you go.
Yeah, now you're getting it.
Now you're running, kids.
Oh, Lord. Okay, so we got this. This is the only
That's
way
a dope one. Cardboard chimney, I gotta say. So, I love how layered it is.
I agree. Uh-oh. Oh, that was supposed to come off.
And I know what? I feel like this is sturdy enough that if I had some G.I. Joes, I could kind of like insert them into the house.
Some what?
Some G.I. Joes.
Some what?
Some G.I. Joes.
Is that like...
What?
What is that?
G.I. Joe's little quarter, three-quarter inch action figures.
What?
Inches?
Should we do the metric system? What should I do?
Sure, okay. Go ahead.
Hasbro? Nintendo's? Oh, wow, I can even use this to rotate around. That's amazing.
Oh, we got this. Oh, we got Spook.
Spock.
Spook. Spock showed up, y'all. Look at him.
He's about to scale.
That's pretty amazing. Wow, it's like he was born for this. Amazing. All right, I'm having too much fun, y'all.
Yeah. Nah, keep going.
Okay, so this part is done.
So yeah, what we have here, what we have here only represents half of what's in this variety kit, also. About half.
Wow.
So
amazing. So many fun things.
Hey, see how much fun we're having? Imagine a little Susie, a little Johnny, and a little Kareem, a little
Yeah, imagine, like as a jaded 31-year-old human, I'm still having an incredible amount of fun with this.
Whose day job involves dealing with boxes all day?
Yeah! I of anybody, should be the most jaded fucker out of this.
Yeah.
You're all diamonds. Anyway.
Who else's takes we might soon get? That'd be really good if he took my signal.
Who's this?
Oh, we'll see if he got the signal.
We'll see if he got the...
Oh, he didn't. All right. Well.
Darn it.
Yeah. Maybe he'll be back.
I hope so.
I would love his takes on this.
Me too.
It's Sasha. That's who it is.
Ah, yes. I would love that.
Yeah.
I would love his takes.
I'm not sure what this
famous,
is.
Famous take maker.
Famous take maker and child maker.
And
Sasha
child, and child oh, yeah. maker. Yes. Okay. All right. You got to shoot. Oh, that piece that fell on the floor. Excuse me. There we go.
Yep. Every piece is important.
Every piece of the Labo.
Every piece. We're using every piece of the Labo.
Use every piece of the Labo. All these people, true. all these settlers got here to start shooting Labo for sport and just left them out in the fields.
Oh,
it went extinct.
Live
you know,
TV.
Yeah.
I love it. Okay. Yeah. All right. Let's.
Oh,
I'm sorry.
We had fun here.
I'm sorry. Oh, my
We're
God.
High on life, is what's going on here.
Yeah.
Sure.
We don't go for the obvious on 420.
No.
We're just building some Labos, man. All right. Let's. Okay. Fold them up.
Chunk, chunk. Okay.
Chunk.
And again, it is mostly boxes of various shapes.
Yeah. What I mean, what is life though?
Right.
And just boxes with various shapes.
I mean, apartment is a box. You know?
Yeah.
And now boxes are smaller boxes.
And now we make the roof. Okay. Cool. Just slot those dudes in there. Chikunk, chikunk.
That's a dang house.
That's a dang.
Like even if all this.
That's a dank house.
Yeah, that's something that we've finished. Like even if you know, there's more to go.
But that's a
product worth showing off.
Look at that.
Yeah.
Look at that. Real sturdy too.
Labo.
Yeah.
Labo.
Where's Spock?
That chimney. Yeah.
Is Spock going on the chimney?
You know what comes out of the chimney is smoke.
Snoke?
Smoke.
Supreme.
I'm saying that house would make a great tobacco pipe.
Yes, correct. Oh no, what are we doing now?
That's a good question.
A and B. Okay, so we're back at the beginning. Get that robot nonsense out of here. I'm past that. I've evolved past your rudimentary robots and have graduated to house. Where's the A sprue?
The A screw?
There was another sheet that says A, because we've got A, B, C, and D.
A, B, C, D.
Because now we're taking out this.
It's over there? Yeah, it's another white one. That top white one, Jeff. Yeah.
Oh, there's no... All the parts are gone.
Oh, did it...
You thought you punched those out?
We might have...
Yeah, punched those out.
Where is it? Is it this thing, maybe? No, it should
look... It looks
look.
Like it's maybe that.
Oh, yeah, because yeah, A is yeah. this thing.
Yeah,
okay,
he
cool.
It up,
so. All right, so anyway, awesome. Moving. Okay, you want to get those D pieces ready?
Out of that part right there. We're building this house.
Pete, you're a Nintendo Switch owner. What do you think about all this? Having now seen it all like live like this.
I don't want to assemble this. It's just really,
I don't
like, want to
assemble
thing.
This.
Like, I don't. That just seems like I'm used to, you know, you build something and then it's done and then you can actually enjoy it. This seems like the building is the point, and I don't like the building at all.
Okay.
So
yeah.
I don't know
the building is very much the point.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. But that's a good point, though.
Haven't you ever heard that the journey is the destination, Pete?
Yeah. The real Nintendo Labo was the friends we made along the way.
Yeah. That's right.
But that's it's important. The building is very much the point here. Like that, yeah.
So okay, let me ask you this then, Pete. Let me bring you in our fourth stool. Is the fourth stool.
Sixth ranger?
Yeah. Does that make you disinterested in like models at all? Like, what about Legos? What about them?
I don't know. I feel like Legos, it's a different kind of thing, because I also feel like there's a lot of anxiety I have like tied up in like trying to make things out of cardboard too, because I feel like I'm not a crafty person at all.
Sure.
Whereas like Legos, you can pull them apart and put them back
together. Oh yeah, those are incredibly sturdy, and this does feel like it might be a little more disposable or something.
Right. But I will say, putting yourself in the mindset that they are selling this for kids to make will help you let go of some of that fear about it being like not durable enough.
Hmm.
Like, because like for some of these, like when you have to like put them in them, you have to have to like smush and jam them in there sometimes.
Yeah,
like,
it's pretty durable. And it's sturdy.
A lot of the design has a lot of like redundancies and like stuff reinforcing other stuff that kind of childproofs it a little bit. So,
but you're like, if I pay for something, I want someone to build it for me.
That's gonna be so good. Just gonna be like,
I'm really not interested in anything I have to make myself, says Pete.
Just put it on Craigslist personal ads. I just want someone to come over and build Labo for me.
Yeah, put it out on totally, you know, legitimate thing. What is it, Fiverr?
Yeah.
Someone will totally do. Yeah,
endures, we trust. Misconnections.
Back door.
Shit.
You need to fold anything?
You know what? Yeah. There you go. Knock yourself out.
Ah, cool. Shiny new nickel.
I got the vision of this. This is a little box.
All right.
I'm not sure what this box is for, but.
Some of these might be, again, the little modules you plug into the house to mess with.
Yeah, I'm looking at this, and this looks like some kind of a large screw.
I mean, you can see it in the bottom right, what it's ultimately going to be.
All right, so there we go. Built that, tucked all those pieces in there. Now you've got that piece.
got this little
I'm sure you can totally manage that yourself. It basically just folds in on itself into a square shape with like little struts sticking out. There you go. And then there's this part, which I have.
But it wants these to be sticking out still.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, so
yeah,
jam this bad boy in there.
This way?
It's a little 1 to 12 hours.
Yeah, hold on. I don't know if that matters. There you go. Hold on, let's go back here.
Yeah, it wants the yeah.
Yeah, this end up sort of thing.
Yeah. So like.
Okay. Are you sure?
No.
Nope. You're not. Rotate it 90 degrees and then attempt again. Okay. It's basically going to be the same regardless.
Yeah.
Button block.
Okay.
Making the button block.
Oh, did it take us back to the beginning here?
Yeah, I did. I brought us back to the beginning. Oh my gosh. Jeff, freaking moving right along.
Making cubes.
Making cubes. All right, I did all that. Thanks. Now, to think this is step 2 of 5. My goodness. All right, did that. Thanks. Boom. Boom, boom, boom. Making a cube sort of thing with the flat ends sticking out. Yep. There you go. Bam, bam, bam. Okay.
And does it want the one with the air? Does it want the arrow on top? Yes. So
yeah. Yeah, like that, dude.
What exactly is that?
That's definitely how it looks in the picture. That's exactly how it looks.
Okay, so we're good.
Yeah, okay, great.
And awesome. Having little markers like those arrows and stuff help you keep everything aligned in good ways.
Whew. Okay. What next? Like you? What you said, Weston?
I don't think I'll pop that.
Okay, we're doing this. Building this little piece. And then
I can hold that over there if you want.
Where?
This one?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, there you go.
There you go.
Many hands make light work. There we go. Whoa. All right.
Let's see. This is a little bit more complicated.
He's gonna be really grateful when he comes back as Will. That he's gonna have all these pre-built for his review for Meg.
Yes.
That's true.
It's like dance for me.
He'll have to build the whole robot kit. So
yeah,
he'll have his work. He's gonna have his work cut out for him. Okay. I was thinking about starting that, and I was like,
no. Heavens, no.
Yeah, I saw one of our competitors said it took them 6 hours to build that.
No thing. Thanks. All right, so now that we've built this, all right, put the cube in my chest.
It's crazy how much even just like the bent cardboard is like springy in a way that serves as a button.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, what? Okay, we're about to find out here.
Look at these little sturdy little boxes on the cardboard.
Yeah.
It's kind of cool.
Jeff, I'm so glad you decided to show up.
So what we've been doing for the past, 15 minutes was making this, which is a button, right? Mm-hmm. For those of us just tuning in.
Yeah.
While I was in the process of making this, I was like, this is not a button.
Yeah.
And then, lo and behold, a freaking
it's
button,
a button,
yo!
Yeah. But the way that the bent cardboard is like provides enough whatever the
this
physics.
This Acme ass button that I built. Look
yeah.
at this.
That's pretty cool.
That is pretty wild.
Yeah.
Anyway, we got that. Put those together. Jam, jam, jam. Try pressing the button. Springs right back, doesn't it? Mm. Sure does. Okay, we're done with that.
Yeah, you gotta do the Destiny button where you hold it to confirm. Or like really all video games.
All video games.
Press X to salute.
Oh, time for more marker stickers. No! Oh, God. Let's see. All right, so we're pushing that through, and we're getting a bunch of these little square stickers.
This should be a dumb question.
Sure.
But why does a house need a button?
Because the buttons, what's going to happen is that you're going to put the switch into the house, mm-hmm. a little virtual pet lives in there, and then these little buttons, when you put them in, are going to do different effects to the house. That's what's ultimately going to happen here.
Okay.
Way to spoil it for me, man.
Oh, sorry. Jeff had a question.
Spoilers.
And don't you want to know if you're working hard for something?
Sure.
That's for anything.
You
at
know
all.
What? Yeah.
We don't always get that.
You're like, dance.
Yeah. But yeah, it's going to be very similar to these piano knobs. Is that it's going to do different the different strips in different orientations is going to do different effects. So.
All right. Stickers applied. Stick.
Stickly?
Those are the IR stickers?
Yes. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yep.
Okay. All right. And another one. New York City, New York State, 10138. That's Stick Stickly's address.
Takes me back to
you're welcome.
High school shop class, actually.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Building these electronic baseball games out of just, you know, just leftover wooden parts. Right. And
it reminds me of like Magnavox Odyssey-ass games where you're just putting like a sheet over a TV and it's just moving one light.
Wow, yeah.
But it's like, yeah, depending on the sheet, yeah.
Okay, so we got that in there. This is going over this part right here. Okay. Got that.
Any questions, Pete?
Cool. No one has questions about cardboard?
No questions about cardboard?
Watch me in silence build.
Would you buy?
Actually, I was just gonna say, how do they give a sense of like the longevity of a lot of these items? Like, I think like the button, for example, I would think that over time that would wear out.
I mean, they haven't put like a number to it or anything.
Yeah. It is cardboard.
Yeah. Again, they've just said, hey, you can print out replacements or just order them. You can buy individual sheets for just like $1.
But buying stuff is for suckers.
That's true.
So.
Is there any return policy? Like, you get Labo and you're like, it's not really for me. Can you bring it back in any way?
Huh.
Maybe that depends on the store, I guess.
I guess so.
Yeah.
Loose garbage bag of cardboard. Here you go.
Some hero is gonna like take those templates and put it on like some sort of like gingerbread or something.
Roll up. That is kind of the community challenge here. Is like, what else can we make Labo out of?
Yeah.
Okay, we did that. Got our.
I feel like if you press that button, it'll launch Spock out of the house. That'd be a cool, pretty cool feature.
God, I hope so. Two more blocks to go.
Three or five.
Making the crank block.
Which sheet is this now?
This is A and B that we need. So you've got A, I think, over there.
I think we already punched everything out of
A. We punched out A already.
And B. B's. What about B? Just needs this part.
Yeah.
Okay.
A bunch of other random assemblies over here.
Nice. Oh, and C and D, apparently.
And C and D.
Out of the bigger builds, I think this actually might be the simplest one too. So it was a good
D is all punched.
Uh-huh.
Wait, B has one more. We don't need B, do we?
Getting that out of there. Okay, great. All right, let's put together this thing.
Are we having a good time? Gut check, like halfway through this house.
Oh man, I don't know. It is a little bit daunting.
Mm-hmm.
I would definitely like, I don't know, probably like take a break or something, take a breather.
And like
I
Wii can't Sports, imagine like Wii Sports, it does tell you to do that sometimes.
I trying to build this with like small children around. Mm-hmm. I'm trying to figure out like what the age limit is on here before they give up, and then I'm like trying to build the house.
I am worried to say this out loud because then it might actually have to happen, but it's going to be bring your child to work day for this company soon enough.
I mean,
why would you utter those cursed words?
That'll keep them busy.
Yeah, that'll wake them up.
That'll wake them up for sure. Rick, what am I doing?
To be fair, we're also working on these hot studio lights.
Yeah,
we're also like trying to be entertaining. Yeah.
Trying to be entertaining, yeah. Time constraints.
We do so much for you people.
Do we?
Yeah, we bring Labo.
Yeah.
Bring the Labo. I need to
question.
Go back here.
So we're an hour in. Can you just kind of recap everything that we actually made during the stream?
Sure. So what we made during the stream are these two RC cars. They use HD Rumble to move forward. We made those. And we've made this much of the house.
This much of a house.
You got it?
A bit of cardboard.
So the amount of time it takes to make these is comparable to like a big video game, like a AAA video game.
It's like building a house.
Yeah. So people worried about this, you know, it's bad to be like, oh, this cost, to try to convert hours spent to quality of a game.
Right.
But in terms of like people like, oh, it's $70, like the amount of time you ultimately take doing everything in it is like not ridiculous for $70.
No. So.
Now you may not care about what that stuff is, but that's a different argument than saying it's not worth it.
Right. I agree.
So. Okay. Also, sometimes video games are for kids. Yeah, sometimes.
I think
gamers forget that kids can enjoy games too.
Yeah. What? How about that? Yeah.
For babies. You know,
kiddos.
That's like a.
Kiddos.
That's like a baby's a toy.
Yeah.
Anyway.
What did I say? I was saying at the end of Kirby Star Allies is like Bayonetta for babies. And like that's a good thing though. Like.
That kids need Bayonetta too.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, not Bayonetta 2.
No.
Bayonetta as well.
Oh no.
That's something else I could play on this.
Yeah. What, Bayonetta?
Yeah.
Oh no. Let's see here.
Does a Labo give you an idea beforehand what the parts are going to be, or do you kind of discover it after you build it?
Well, I mean, it's giving you.
Did you know the button was going to be a button?
Yeah, I mean, it gives you a picture of what the finished product is.
Yeah.
And like before, it demarks all of these sprues with different colors based on whatever project you're undertaking.
Okay.
So we got that. We got this one little.
But to your point, I do think there is a bit of a mystery element to it, too, to see how it all comes together.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, we're cramming this bad boy in there.
I will say, I wish in the instructions that there was an option for, like, here's a way to like divvy up instructions so that multiple people could be working on different angles of a thing at the same time.
What?
Maybe let the people figure that out.
Right, but like see, it's only showing one step at a time. So like,
oh, I see what you're saying.
You know what I mean, like, yeah, like you could be working on one button while Alice does another button or something like that. You know, and I wish that there was an option for that or something like that.
Maybe you can hit two people, go split screen.
Yeah, totally. Yeah.
We have multiple switches, and each one gets a different. Right. Menu.
You could do that. Like we could probably do that.
Speed run the Nintendo Labo here
Nintendo
in a minute.
Nintendo should hire us for Labo 2.0.
Yeah, good as Justin Acklin.
Hey, Miyamoto.
Yeah, Eddie Garcia.
Hey, people.
Justin's great. But yeah, as great as these manuals are, I think they're really great.
Yes. These are very clear instructions. Yeah. I haven't really had too much. In regards to like hang-ups yet. Wow, we actually already built this, I think. Yep, we sure did. And we're speeding right along.
One of the cubes.
Yep, one of the cubes.
In your chest, Sam.
What? No. Put it in my chest. This part needed to come out though. That's fine. Okay.
This might be our longest stream since the drill bracket.
Drill okay. Nintendo. Both family-friendly products.
Wow, we are legit making like
a little crank that.
Cranks.
A little Soulja Boy.
Yeah.
Crank it.
Ain't no point to the game. You just got the timer winding potion. Don't run out. You're like Mario from the future.
You're like Mario from the future, except he's like a little preppy dude.
He's got a business suit. Whoop! I just sucked your bitch ass out. That's the best piece of gaming criticism known to man.
Hang it up, guys. We're done. Everything that needs to be said about video games has been said. Thank you, Soulja Boy.
Oh, man. I love that video so much.
It's a real good video. Hang it up, fellas. We're done.
Is the game to play? Are you smoking, get high, or are you drinking, get drunk? It's called Brain.
Making
a crank.
Making a cricket crank here. All right, that's done.
All right.
Cool. It a crank. Forward.
Crank three.
Oh Jesus. Okay. This is the real killer.
All these buttons are gonna need stickers. So.
Yep. Oh my gosh.
I'm gonna.
Requires a steady hand to apply a sticker.
Carefully.
It's like Operation almost.
Every other.
I'm gonna press this.
Do it.
And to think,
that's a good button.
Like 15 minutes ago, that was just a sheet.
Yeah. to think 4 hours ago, this was just sheets.
A freaking piano.
Yeah.
How's about that? Okay, now we got these bad boys. These little triangle boys we're going to stick on here. Oh, crap. Okay.
Oh, triangles? Oh, I didn't have to do any triangles.
Get me my freaking tweezers, yo.
I didn't do any. It was for child's hands, child's fingers.
There are some hard folds in these smaller
yeah,
pieces.
Yeah, if there's anything little children are great at, it's fine motor control. Oh, thank you. Oh, my God. Yes, thank you. Hold on. Hold on, let me get my jeweler's monocle. Let me get my loop.
You have a great prop department.
This is amazing.
Weston, you have kids. Do you think they would like this?
They wouldn't have the patience.
Yeah, I'm trying to envision Teddy doing something like this, and it just ain't happening. Okay.
Oh, I see how this works. This tucks into here. Let's see.
Hold on, let me get my...
Oh, this is the hardest fold
yet. Let me get
yet.
My Citadel paints and primers out.
The Citadel? Let's see.
And then one long boy.
Wait a minute, I think I got this one. Here we go.
I'm glad Will isn't here.
I'm not sure what this does.
He'll be back next week.
Adamant.
Any Will fans out there in the audience?
Adamant anti-boy.
Oh, just using the phrase boy?
Yeah.
He's going to love God of War then.
Tune in next week, y'all. Tune in next week for our takes on God of War.
Watch that. Read our review right now. In the meantime, we have a review and like all the features and junk too, like how to's and tips and stuff.
Okay.
Like best video game dads.
Yeah, just like getting started in God of War. We have a lot of God of War content too, so don't worry.
Okay, slot that bad boy in there. Forward.
One more piece.
One more.
We're going to finish this house.
Yeah.
We're going to finish this.
And play with this house.
I hope
we
so.
We can go to like 4:30. That's not insane, right?
Are we?
Okay, yeah.
So we got this
bad
boy.
I just want Spock to be happy.
Same. He deserves a place to live.
I mean, he's dead, so he's happier than all of us.
Well, Spock lives forever. Leonard Nimoy is no longer with us.
No, Spock's dead. Star Trek Beyond.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
But they'll probably bring him back in some kind of weird reboot
They're going to have him in Discovery. Yeah. Be a young Spock.
Don't worry. Yeah. He'll be
Spock,
there.
Young Spock,
Y-U-N-G? Young Spock.
What is this? Is this all done? Let's get rid of this. Mm-hmm. Yeah, there we go.
Let's get rid of this, the scrap.
Get rid of that nonsense. I don't need it. Okay, it's this one long boy.
We were able to build this in a cave. With a box of scrap.
Obadiah.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Rubber bands.
Oh.
I can't be trusted. Oh. Okay, anyway.
And so the bands are also in the box too, huh?
Yep.
Yep, sure are. Oh my God.
Look at this. They give you a significant amount of bands and what is this? Like
there's a banquet of choking hazards in this box, yo.
Washers.
Yeah. A lot of that's for the fishing rod, but yeah.
Yeah. My first plumbing set?
Or for my mouth.
It's great. When you build the fishing rod, it has kind of these like three telescoping pieces.
Oh,
and
they
call them Papa Bear, Mama Bear, and Baby Bear.
Yeah.
That's what I would call them.
Yeah. So it's small, like, it's time to slide into Papa Bear.
No comment.
Yeah. We might have, that might be in our video. We might have gotten video of that, actually. So.
That video exists.
Yeah.
It's somewhere. All right. This is as good as it's getting. All right. This is so far the peak difficulty right here. This is playing on expert mode. Oh, jeez. Okay. Oh, jeez, Rick. Okay, we got to pull that pot through there. Okay.
So this is a little complex now.
Yeah, I would not trust a child with this.
Your parents helped you hook it up.
Yeah, they did.
Yeah.
What are you referencing? By
the old NES commercials where
your parents helped you hook it up.
Yeah. Octorox 2.
With toast and juice to make it
complete.
Thank you for the commentary. All right, so we got this. We got this boy right here. All right. One little slotty boy.
Good.
Okay, that goes in. Zim zam zam. Ribbidam dam.
Cubes maybe.
I'll be back.
Sure.
There's something I'm going to do in the meantime too.
Okay.
And maybe one of
no,
the...
No, no, no. Let's see it till it's done.
Oh, there we go.
Where is this? Did we forget something?
Look to my man, to me. Is that it? That little
what?
Box? That? Is that it?
Sure not. Sure ain't.
This is more rectangular.
Oh, is it this and C? There's still a piece in that.
Well, punch it out anyway.
Okay.
We're going to need it. Did I miss a step here? Oh, this is definitely it, though.
Okay.
All right.
A building
dodged
we will go,
a bullet.
A building we will go. So you've been doing a lot of the construction. What has been the most difficult part of the construction so far?
So far, the decals, because my my hands are not used to delicate labor. They're good for punching through walls, not so much handling delicate
little
stickers.
God hand action?
A little bit, yeah.
We referenced God hand on a Labo stream.
I mean, I didn't. He did.
Gamers come in many flavors.
All right, so we got this.
Famous 3 out of 10, God hand.
Did that. Got that little, got that little boy. Now
it's like a T-beam almost.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. Yeah.
What I'm doing is there's a little kind of.
How's that connection feel?
Pretty secure.
All right.
Pretty secure. As secure as just about anything else.
Yeah,
in
a little
this.
Thor's hammer action happening.
Yeah,
here.
Just a little bit. Just a little bit. Okay, good. I didn't mess that up. Congratulations, Alice. There we go.
That's one of the cubes.
That's one of the cubes. You made this already.
Not sure which cube it is, though.
It's definitely the one with the little pieces in it here. it is the latrine. What if it was, Weston? But what if it was? All right, so we got this. Just slotting it in, I think.
Oh,
jump the gun.
Yeah.
Jump the gun.
You thought you were smarter than Labo.
Yeah. Are you smarter than a Labo?
Are you smarter than a Labo? Wait, hold on. Back.
So the issue here is I was folding and I decided to fold this, the cube. But we need to open the cube to pull the rubber band through, it looks like.
Yeah, so I've got a... Hold on, I'm going to slot that sucker back in there. Oh, come on. Oh, my gosh. This is... All right, so we got that. Those parts are on the top or something? Ooh.
It's hard to tell what the cube completely assembled
is supposed to look like. Yep.
Yeah.
Oh, wait. Nope. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go.
Alice has the vision.
I have the vision. That's right.
She's going to make it.
She's going to make it. Anyway, we're going to pop these bad boys out. Oh, without tearing anything.
See, that shows how sturdy it is once it's constructed.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, wow. Okay. Oh, it's like a little key! Oh, wow! so pleased. Anyway. Alright, so...
All right.
Whew! That wasn't difficult!
Alright!
That wasn't such a chore. All right, so we got that bad boy.
Rubber bands through, hooked.
Rubber bands. More rubber bands.
Folded keys in.
That's this bad boy. That's this sucker right here. And we're putting that right here. Right on the refrigerator.
This is way more complex than I thought it would be. But I like the fact that it is, though.
Yeah, again.
If I had a child and I was like, I wanted to partake of an adult beverage and watch the game.
Yeah.
Give a little. Oh,
this will shut him up.
Yeah.
This will shut him up for a minute.
I love the names of your fake children, Jeff.
Yeah, please go on. What is it? What do we have so far?
Tanisha, Kareem, Johnny, and Susie. My four children.
Oh. That little cute little home you built for yourself. I love this. I'm getting so much insight into the world of Jeff today. Why don't we hang out, Jeff?
Yeah,
you know. Oh well, we're hanging out right now. No, I mean like outside.
No,
of work,
Jeff
man.
Hangs out with you on his own terms.
Sometimes that's so right.
I hang out with you guys every day.
Sometimes you know. Sometimes you're at the arcade and you're there with your friend, and then you're at the arcade and you turn around and Jeff's there.
Huh.
Yeah.
Or sometimes you're at a wedding and then one of us shows up for some reason.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was the most
fun story.
Thing.
Fun story. By
yeah,
that.
Inside baseball about all our personal lives right here. I'm just trying to make this little dude.
Make a little dude.
Oh, it's a little.
Is it a little man's?
Yeah.
What's that guy from Weston? Help me out. Little guy from SNL in the 70s, Mr.
Bill.
Mr. Bill.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Yeah. Mr. Bill.
That's.
I'm just gonna look up a picture of how this is supposed to look, so I know what I'm doing.
Right. So how far along are we?
We are.
I think you just have one more button left.
One more button.
One more button. All right.
Oh, I see. So these are all supposed to be like interchangeable.
Yep.
Okay. So there's the button, the key, and the crank.
And so they all aren't necessary to finish the house.
I guess not.
No, but just for its full range of functionality. Right. Yeah.
Okay.
Nothing's
can
ever
I,
necessary.
Can I get your?
Anything.
Oh well, it needs to be this one.
Nothing really matters.
What were you gonna say?
Is that it? Is that really it?
Oh, so what's this little guy right here?
Is that it?
Maybe that's it. Let's see.
Okay.
All right, so you're gonna have to put that switch in there.
All right, let's get that switch in there.
I have to get rid of Mr. Nimoy too. Oh.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, careful. Carefully.
There we go.
Carefully. Okay. There we go. All right. And then this bad boy. Play now. Okay, so here you go. That's a house. God damn, I am exhausted.
All right, let's
play
let's
now.
Let's play like 10 minutes of the house. That'll be like 4:30 or
3.
It's
two,
almost 4:20.
One.
Let's play with our fake house.
How appropriate. This house is getting real high right now.
I also built this little cardboard man.
Yeah.
Or whatever, person.
Yeah.
Doot, doot. Anyway.
So you can do stuff like the way there's a Joy-Con here, they'll show off like. You'll have the RC car hit. If you put like tape on this, you can be like a target, and then the Joy-Con will vibrate and it'll fall
over.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. All right. Oh my gosh. Okay, so depending on which of these things we have slotted in here, it appears that we have different activities we can engage in with our little trouble that we have in here.
Yeah, it's a virtual pet type thing. Yeah. The
okay, so I've currently got the crank in here, and I'm gonna.
You going to crank that?
Oh my god, I hope it works. Wow!
It was all worth it.
Oh, jeez. That is really, really neat, actually. So, yeah, as you can see, I'm cranking this little crank, and this little Playmobil thing is going.
This little crank that you built your own dang self.
That's right.
I'm actually almost.
You're getting emotional.
I'm getting more emotional than Corey Barlog at the launch of his title, God of War.
Jeff, you want to have a go? Maybe with the big button?
Get it, man. No. Oh, wait a minute. Can I bounce this? Can we get a close up on this? He can shake it like a little land farm. Like a little shit.
I'm going to turn this crank. I'm impressed
turn
by the crank.
Turn the crank, buddy.
This is really cool. Look at this.
When you put in multiple buttons, it launches a little mini game, I think.
Look at this. This is all just cardboard, people.
Cardboard and like one rubber band, right? Or you, tell me.
Two?
Yeah.
Two?
Yeah. One, a single rubber band.
Yeah.
Single rubber band. All right, so let's slot the button in here. Okay, so immediately when we did that, it swapped over to this cool little like hamster wheel sort of thing.
Jeff, you want to push the button from over on your end?
All right.
Please. Whoa, okay, that just like opens a hatch for some reason.
Okay.
Oh, okay, so we're running here. We're charging something up. You can see that at the top of the screen there's some type of thing that's filling up, which is really cool. I'm afraid I'm going to break this crank. I'm turning it so rapidly.
Let's test the durability of the Labo.
Yeah, we have another one of these.
Stress test Labo.
Yeah. Read it for how many hours of gameplay.
Press the button. Let's see what happens now.
Yeah, please.
Oh. You got...
We got a fish for some reason. Oh, feed the pet the food you get. Remove the block and return the room to normal.
So take out one of them is what it's saying, yeah.
Okay, so if we take one out, it'll return it to normal.
And you got
that. Oh, wait, now we got this anchovy thing in here, a little sardine. Touch the food to have the little tribble guy eat it. Okay, so there we go, got that.
So it had to work for its food.
Yeah.
Mm. Try putting one of them, there's a bottom slot also, I believe.
What?
On the bottom of the house. Is there not a spot? Yeah, there is.
Okay, so you can hold it up and have all three in here.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's
get
that.
It's going to get really wild.
There you go.
Oh, wow, so like the different combinations potentially induce different games.
Yeah.
Colorful
so these mini games have, you know, a fair amount of depth, but they are mini games.
Right.
You know.
Okay. Oh, I didn't want to close that shit. House. Go back to the house. All right, so we're here. We're back at the thing. Calcium-rich bone of some sort. Oh, okay, this is just showing me the different types of food that I can feed him. All right, I'm going to take this one out here. Let's take that out. Okay, so now we have a microwave for some reason.
Mm.
All right, that sets a timer. Does this do anything? The crank does nothing.
Maybe you could put food in there if you had any.
Maybe.
Yeah.
I'm a little curious. Hold on. What? Wow, I am thoroughly puzzled as to what needs to happen here.
Okay, that'd be my guess, is that you need
food. You know what? Yeah. You know what? F that. We're going to something else.
Okay.
Okay, we got the little... Oh, cool. Okay, so...
The shape of water.
Here we go. Okay, we're going to... There we go, buddy. Oh, that's cool. Okay, let's see if... You know what? I could be really bad with this, but we're filling up the tank with some water.
Yeah.
And thankfully, he has a flotation device. Uh-oh. Apparently, he is also aquatic.
Yeah, you can't kill this thing.
Oh,
damn it.
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool. So we had a dehydrate. This is really weird. Man.
But like,
we had a dehydrated sardine in here before, and we added water, and now it's an actual live fish.
But that's such a Nintendo
science.
That's such a Nintendo kind of detail. Like the WarioWare, and like all that weird Nintendo specificity is totally in here too. Like,
how do I get rid of the water? Is the problem?
Try. What if you take it out? If you take out the
plug?
Yeah.
Oh, that'll...
Yeah.
Oh, that done did it. There we go. Let's get a freaking plug up in here. Button. Jelly beans! Okay, so this apparently produces a jelly bean thing. Oh! There we go. Okay.
It's a good button.
It's a real good feeling button.
Yeah, it's even just like
that's
fiddling
the MVP
with
in the buttons.
Yeah.
Here, watch this. That's really fun. That's really satisfying to just press that and see these little jelly beans pop out of here. But yeah, you could feed him the jelly beans and he turns a different color. That's really cool. I hate that his mouth is also his face. This is like some Demogorgon level stuff. That is really unsettling, actually. Okay, so what if I put this in the bottom? All right, so if I put it in the bottom, I get this thing, which is... What? Oh!
I was changing the wallpaper.
So, yeah, take a look at this. It's really like this Rube Goldberg-ass machine here. So if I hold it, it pulls this drawstring, which then changes the decor of the room.
Oh, okay.
There we go. Again, also a very good feeling like switch here.
It's the power of Labo.
Yes.
Power of Labo. What do we have on the other side here? Oh, that just puts the, that just, again, gives me more water.
How are we feeling about these results compared to what it took to bring us here?
You know, if I was maybe, like, 11.
You're right. Yeah.
I would be pretty happy with this. And it's definitely a diversion for an afternoon.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. whether or not that's the same level of diversion that you would pay for, like, I don't know, Splatoon or something. I have a difficult time seeing this, but as a platform, I am thoroughly impressed.
Yes. Cool. If I had a child, or even if I had a little downtime and I wanted to build, this Labo's pretty solid.
Yeah, I mean, never mind this being like an actual toy. I'm really excited about the possibilities for this extending into like sort of like a crafts.
Totally.
A craft sort of thing.
Their coding garage stuff is like shockingly robust. And I'm surprised they're not leading more with that. Like,
Yeah, I would be almost more excited to see some of that.
Yeah, you could like onboard kids like a Raspberry Pi with some of this stuff.
Yeah, like that's what I'm really excited to see, because Lego Mindstorms, man, that was some
that was
stuff.
So good.
That was some stuff right there. Yeah, I really like that.
Me too. I was super into that.
Yeah, that was really, really fun stuff. Anyway.
And in fact, this is also then also a video game machine. That
I mean, never mind the fact that I would already have to own a Switch in order to engage with this product, you know. That might be a little much. But anyway, so that, I mean, that's my take.
Yeah. All right, so that's Labo. So we with the house, the piano here, and these RC cars, that's three out of the five Toy-Con that come with the variety kit. That's $70. There's also the robot suit that we didn't have, but that's $80. Those are both available now. We're going to keep messing around with this. I'll probably have some more detailed impressions on Geek.
Sure.
I'm sure when Will's back, he'll have a chance to mess around with this. We'll have coverage on PC Mag. But yeah, that's thanks for really doing the work here.
The work that
was shown. My work is more invisible.
No, this is great.
Yeah, Alice, Jeff, thanks so much. Thanks for watching. We'll be back next week with God of War, finally.
Yes.
It's on Facebook, Twitch, and yeah.
That's it.
That's it.